Mr. Chairman, the world now faces more floods, droughts, storms, and wildfires requiring an urgent response.
Our people, the world, the planet needs our actions now, not next year, not in the next decade. Thank you.
COP28 is the top gathering for all decision makers. So they are going to have the first-hand account and listening to what the science says.
The COP process is a global set of negotiations about what should every country do? Can they identify the technologies? How do they put those technologies in place? How do companies inside these countries build new businesses around low emissions, build new businesses around removing carbon from the atmosphere? Our impact on COP is going to come in lots of different ways. First and foremost, we run the Ocean Pavilion. This is one of the main ways that information about the science of the oceans is fed into the COP process. We also have scholars working on lots of different topics. So it's very exciting to see academic research being applied in the real world to making international cooperation much more effective.
I was able to attend COP26, and this was a very unique experience as a student because I had the opportunity to look at how negotiations at the international level happen. I'm particularly interested in the conversation about blue carbon. A lot of my research is in mangrove forests. It's very important because it has been shown that mangrove forests can sequester even 10 times more than any other tropical forest. However, many mangrove forests have been impacted. There has been high rates of deforestation and pollution. And so thinking about how we can restore those mangroves so they can effectively trap carbon is something that scientists are still working and trying to understand.
So I run two major research groups on campus. One is the Deep Decarbonization Initiative. That's all about how do we eliminate the emissions that cause global warming. The second group is at the Scripps Institution of Oceanography on how do we pull carbon dioxide that's already up in the atmosphere. How do we pull it out and put it safely underground or safely in the oceans? If we're going to stop and then reverse global warming, we need carbon removal to work at scale.
My research at UC San Diego is focused on understanding the relationship between people and the ocean through time. The landscape, the coastal zones, the marine ecosystems, and those stories can shed light into issues of social justice, into issues of injustice, environmental injustice, that tie to the ability of people to respond to climate impact. Archaeology gives us the tool to look back. By recovering the past, we can then understand better how identity is woven into these responses to climate change.
UC San Diego is a hub to address health equity across the globe through the addressing of climate change health impacts in low and middle income countries. What we're trying to do is reach out to areas that are going to be impacted first and learn from that and apply policies to help these countries as well as help us into the future. Policy is the solution because we have a race against time with climate change impacts.
Almost nothing that's fundamentally important in climate change that sits in an individual discipline. We have to work in teams, and that's what you see across the campus here at UC San Diego.
This complexity and this need to be able to straddle multiple disciplines and build partnerships, we are able to be better at identifying and answering the hard questions to this very complex problem that we are facing. UC San Diego and Scripps Institution of Oceanography are leaders in understanding the oceans. We will be able to continue helping to push the needle toward issues of justice and towards finding solutions to climate change.